Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you so much for joining us today. Today, we're going to talk about Roth conversions with Coach Dave Pimper. Dave is going to try and squeeze in a relatively short amount of time. It'll probably take about, it's designed to take about 20 minutes, all there is to know and everything that you can use to help you grow your business and be educated, or at least have access to education regarding doing Roth conversions. So looking forward to a great webinar here this morning, or not this morning anymore, this afternoon. My, how time flies. So let me make sure we all have everything ready to go. Dave is going to join us in just a second and make sure you all can see the screen. Perfect. Looks like we're set up good. And looks like we can be heard, so good deal. So Dave will be joining us here in just a moment to talk about Roth conversions. Just to give you a little history about Dave, just so you know that the person that you're dealing with is a credible source. Dave has been in the business since 1981. He is a licensed insurance agent. He is a Series 65, Series 6, Series 7, Series 24, which is supervisory licensing. So he can supervise security sales. He has done radio and actively doing radio right now. He's been actively coaching a number of our producers over the past 12, 14 years now, from everything from practice management to Social Security claiming to seminars. He has a couple seminars that he makes available. One is regarding Social Security claiming, and the other is regarding eight taxation mistakes. And then, of course, he also actively coaches on Retirement Boss Radio. So really a credible resource that we are fortunate to have with us today, the coach, Mr. Dave Pimper, going to talk about now Roth conversions. Good afternoon, Dave.
Steve, thank you very much. I appreciate it. And thank you, everybody, for being on a Thursday afternoon. Hopefully it's as gorgeous in your neck of the woods as it is in Nebraska. So you can really tell that fall has come. And in Nebraska football, we're on a roll. We've won two games in a row, so that's really something exciting if you're from Nebraska. Okay, so my name's Dave Pimper. Been around for a long time, business for 40-plus years. Been coaching with IAMS and associated with IAMS for 17 of those, coaching for 16 of them. So, and I coached before that with independent reps, but everything has always been around marketing and production and sales process. So we're This is quick hitting. When those are sales processes of quick hitters. So this is about a 10-minute webinar. This is not a long one. We're going to talk about Roth conversions today. If you have any questions, certainly type them in, and I'll be more than happy to help you with that. So you got to ask yourself this question. Why are Roth conversions so timely right now when it comes to marketing? Well, one of the reasons is, as you already know, if you're in the industry, pensions are disappearing. Yeah, they're not going to be around any longer, and people want some kind of income source. What's beautiful about Roth, if you put it within a fixed index and you do say some type of a rider, all of a sudden you've got kind of the best of both worlds, where you've got an income for life that is contractually guaranteed, that's sustainable, and you don't pay taxes on it. I mean, those are four or five questions that it's hard for your client to say no, they don't really want that in the future, if they're paying, you know, taxation, which majority of the people we work with do. It gives the high income investor a chance to save a lot of money, and that's long term. Now, not right now. If you convert, no, you got to pay taxes on that, but down the road, there's no RMDs for the spouse, and even the RMD for the children, there is one, but there's no taxation on it. There's no income limits. There used to be, but there's not now. Now, when you start talking about Roth conversion specifics, yeah, it's taking a traditional IRA. It could be a 401k, 403b, et cetera, but basically it's an IRA. Say you've got $500,000 in that IRA. You're going to take $50,000 in Roth, convert it. That $50,000 is a taxable transaction. That's why a lot of people don't do it. They don't like paying that taxes now. But if you ask the average person, where's tax rates going up in the future? Are they going up or are they going down? Everybody says they're going up. You know why? Because they're smart. I absolutely think they will go up also. So what happens is that it turns from deferred into tax-free. Now, when you become age 72, no, there's no RMDs. That's for the owner, or that's for the spousal privilege on the wife. Okay? And you just don't want to pay that Roth conversion taxation money. Say you convert 50 grand, it's going to cost you 15 grand of taxation. You need to pay that with some other investment that's not in that IRA, some other thing that's not, you're not going to go and have to pay extra taxes on when you take it on out. Okay? Now, there's a five-year rule. Every conversion has a new five-year rule. That's not the same with just an IRA. A Roth IRA, once you start it, that 5 years, and let's say it's 5 years down the road, put another one in, it's instantly tax-free, not with conversions. No, everyone starts a new five-year rule from that date. Okay? So what do you got to consider before your Roth conversion? Well, if you think rates are going to go down in the future, or your income, your tax rate's going to go down a lot, no, it may not be a good mode of operandi for you. How soon you need the money? You really need to let it sit in there, and gather before you start taking money. And I say that's anywhere 5 years plus. I mean, get out of that 5 year standpoint of going in and being taxed. Don't want to pay the conversion money with that IRA. The age of the client. I mean, I had a client in his 80s, has like five daughters, and he gave money through a Roth conversion to everything he turned his account. So when he actually passed, which he did, that money went into the inheritance in a tax-free standpoint, not a taxable standpoint. Okay? And remember, in provisional income, which is how Social Security figures out whether you've reached those tax brackets or not. Provisional income is your modified adjusted gross income plus half of your Social Security income plus all of your municipal bond income. That's it. It's not half of your muni bond income or half of your tax-free Roth money. Roth is not considered in provisional income. So people are going to have tons of Roth and maybe still not pay any taxes on their Social Security. So why is you as the advisor, why should you go in and introduce Roth conversions? You know why? Because nobody else is doing this. I'm telling you right now, very few advisors. Because how much money do you make from a Roth conversion? Nothing. Unless you're converting new money. It's usually done in kind. But I'll tell you what. To really find out if they need that Roth conversion, you got to look at their whole entire picture. Their income, their net worth, their assets, their expenses. Because you get a really good feeling of what they have. There certainly could be something there they might be able to work with. It just creates opportunities to do more business. Okay. Ed Slott, and is the retirement savings time bomb. His quote is: "Roth IRA conversions are the silver lining to the economic crisis. These may be your lowest tax rates you'll see for the rest of your life." They're low right now. Whether you love Trump, hated Trump, his tax rates are lower. Brackets lessened and the standard deduction is high. It's going to be sunsetting out after 2015. Oh, I went the wrong way. Let's see if I can go the right way here. Yeah, so here we go. So, who might be a good candidate? I want to make sure I'm on the right thing. Yeah, there I am. Well, someone who wants to manage their tax liability. I'm telling you, those are higher net worth folks. They prefer flexible penalty-free distribution opposite from a Roth. If you have a company retirement plan, here's what happens is, if you're still working and you're to the age of 72, what's interesting is if you have a Roth, you are going to pay required minimum distributions on that money at age 72, no matter if it's Roth or not, just like traditional. Well, why wouldn't you move it to an IRA unless you need that money? You're darn right you would. And if you don't need money, for living expenses, yeah, just like my my friend, who is the older friend with his five or six daughters, left them all a tax-free legacy because he converted when he was still, you know, was still living. Pretty cool. So who may not be a good candidate? So someone who's not in a higher tax bracket upon retirement, or no tax bracket at all. Maybe they're not paying taxes. No, tax-free doesn't help someone who's not paying taxes. Higher the higher tax bracket you're paying, the more you're paying, the stronger it is for you. If you can't afford to pay the taxes out of personal money, shouldn't do it. I mean, you can pay from other, but non-taxable money. It could be other Roth money, but non-taxable money. I think that's what's important. So here's a myth. It's only good for young people. Remember my banker client friend, older guy? Yeah. He was able, while he was living, he was able to set up at virtually no charge cost to himself except for this taxation, but enables his kids to get this money who are all doing well financially and not pay any taxes on that money. How cool is that? And what also happens is that it may take 6 to 8 years, depending on the interest rate and what your tax bracket is, but that's also very important that you've got some time if you want to be able to participate of that plus side of the Roth in Roth conversion. You got to give it enough time to work for you. There's an old saying that says, procrastination is my sin. It brings me constant sorrow. I really shouldn't practice it. Perhaps I'll stop. May never come, does it? No, it's like free beer tomorrow. I got a sign in my man cave that says that. Well, I'll tell you this. If you saw something on Roth conversions that tweaked a chord, then you need to mark yes. And Steve Murray is going to put up a poll. And that poll is, would you like more information on Roth and Roth conversions or just marketing or sales process for that fact? I do sales process coaching. And so if a person wants more information on Roth, just give me a call. But what happens if you really want to get in depth on Roth and Roth conversions and really the ins and outs, the skinnies? Yeah. I mean, for $200 for a 45-minute, and you've got some handouts that come with that. If you want the sales process, you know, I charge $200 per session. That's $600. I'm a coach, and I'm a producer too. And not many coaches are still producing. A lot of coaches are people who were successful in personal sales, and I have been. I enjoy this business immensely. I enjoy coaching people up to get better at what they do so they can more production can come in. You're helping more clients and more production comes in. So if you'd like to get more information on Roth conversions, certainly mark yes. And Steve, I know that we may have had a couple questions. I think I saw them pop in, but I'm going to turn this over to you.
Thanks, Dave. Appreciate that. Great job as always. You're right. There are a couple of questions. The first is, can we receive a copy of these slides? So you'll have available to you a copy of the actual webinar. We'll send that to you or at least a link to it after the event. You can also attach or have a peek at these. They're all attached to our website. So that's www.imzinc.com. Just go to the YouTube. You'll see a little YouTube icon. Click on that, and that will be up there. We have an older version of this one. By older, I mean probably 3 or 4 weeks ago that we did, that you can pop in and see now if you want to go over some points. Or if you want to wait till this one gets up, usually it's probably going to be within probably 24 hours before it's up on that website. So yes, you can see this again. We don't actually send the slides out to you, however. So I had a couple questions on the five-year rule. And so that's why I kind of went back to that. Can you, the five-year rule, does it pertain, I would guess based on your slide, it pertains to conversion by conversion. So if somebody converts an IRA to a Roth IRA, and establishes that Roth IRA account today, Dave, do they, and then let's say they convert more next year, is it per the deposit or per the age of the total account?
No, per the conversion. So if you do five years in a row, you'll have laddered. You got one coming due in 5 years. Then you got to wait the next year's 5 years, and next year's 5 years, and next year's 5 years. The reason that gets confusing, because with a Roth IRA non-conversion, you start the first year. Say you start right now, October the 13th of 22. I put in a Roth. I put in my $7,000, $6,000 plus my $1,000 top up after 50. I got my $7,000 in there. Next year, October 13th of 2023, I put in another $7,000. Well, you don't start all over again. You start from the first one on an IRA. So after 5 years, your money instantly on an IRA is tax-free, not with a conversion. Every new conversion starts a new five-year rule.
Got it. So if they're making new deposits into a Roth IRA, then basically that five-year rule starts from when that when the account is established. But if it's a conversion, which I think is what's leading to the confusion here based on the way the questions are worded, if it's a conversion, then it's based on the 5 years from that particular conversion.
That's right. Some people say, you know, if you wanted to be absolutely just never mess anything up, if you got audited, you would do a new conversion in different investments everyone would be new. But do mm-hmm. people do that? Of course not. No, I mean, yeah. If I'm just making this up, but let's say it's a fixed index annuity and it, you know, you're able to put in money year after year. Well, it's so much simpler keeping it all in one account, but you just need to keep good record keeping on that.
Yeah, and the particular question here is from one of our producers that actually is with Athene, and a couple of carriers do it like Athene does, where if you do a conversion, if you're doing a systematic conversion, you know, you can establish that initial account, and then they make what they call child accounts. So it's not a whole new policy, but it kind of is. And so they all list them all in the same policy number, but they're child accounts to the original conversion parent account. It allows it to be a systematic process, if you will, or automated process, that conversion. So
that's right. Steve, I got a question for you. I mean, sure. You know, it's interesting because with your wealth management now within IAMS, I know that you've got a fair amount, and including myself, I do quite a bit of securities. But it seems like it's taken a while for the insurance industry, you know, on whether it be inherited IRAs or Roth conversions, it seems like they've always kind of been a step late compared to the brokers. But it seems like lately, for whatever reason, they've kind of made a big effort to get caught back up, haven't they? And most insurance companies now can really with index, fixed index or fixed, most can do the same type of thing that securities, which wasn't the case 15, 20 years ago.
No, I would agree with that. And I think some of the reason for that is that some of the players that have entered into the index annuity market are more traditionally considered, secure, like the mm-hmm. these big, mm-hmm. like Apollo with Athene and what's the Magic Johnson Enterprises with Equitrust. You know, they come from a financial background. So they're like, yeah, we should be able to do this over on the insurance side. And they're right. And so they're more.
I don't know if our compliance company would let me say magic when you're talking about fixed index annuities. What do you think?
Magic Johnson Enterprises.
But right now they are kind of magic, aren't they? I tell you absolutely. If you've got lost money for your client right now, you are at zero, you're a hero. But you know what? When it comes to times like this, pretty darn good. You're darn right.
Let's see if we have any more questions. You know, I mentioned Retirement Boss Radio before you got on, as the fact that you have radio. So there's a couple questions about that. How does that sound on the radio when you talk about Roth conversions? Because what they're looking for is like a soundbite that you might say to a client on Roth conversions. What does that sound like, for instance, when you do it on the radio show?
Yeah, I would just say, look at. If you think you're paying too much taxes in time out, how many people think they're paying too much taxes? Everyone. Everyone. Yeah.
And
you're not participating in Roth conversions for whatever misunderstood information you heard. Yeah. Give us a call. I mean, give us a call. Let us just go in and give you some ideas of, I'm not saying every person that fits like Cinderella's slipper, but give us a call. So we can just go in and see if we can reduce your taxes. If we can, that's money in your pocket. 888-975. That's how I would do it.
Got it.
I mean, that's how I would do it. Yeah. Because remember, marketing, like the Timber Boss Radio is a, and we know, see, we just put up a brand new person. And actually he's kind of unique. I mean, he's a financial advisor, but he also has a law degree and he does estate planning. So they kind of work hand in hand, but he just is our newest Retirement Boss Radio recruit and out in the big city on the East Coast. I think he'll do very well. And you know, we just put one up, actually changed stations into a big station up in the Grand Rapids area. Just a beautiful time. This is for Curtis. I mean, we've been waiting for a year to get this, but it's on the largest. It's the Rush Limbaugh, which was station up there. And it is at 9 o'clock on Saturday morning.
Mm,
you just can't get a better timing for that. Yeah. So we're excited, but yeah, but what happens is those are our shows. They're hosted by, and we put them all together. I am in Dave Pimper, and I coach you. The been doing radio for over 30 years now, 33 years of my 41 years I've done radio. And what we're doing is just getting in front of those people. But the reason Steve brought it up is because he knows that Roth conversions, it's a hot topic. Because mm-hmm. most people don't do it. Most people aren't, they just heard, it's like annuities. They're not sure why guarantees can't be good in a time like this. They just heard they're bad. You know, I mean right. When they find out how good they are, then it's like, wow, that's different than I thought. And that's what people look at Roth conversions. But it certainly is one of the top 10 things that I try to mention quite often, because it certainly does bring people in through the doors.
So James's question regards how the taxes are best handled for a Roth conversion. So I know there's a couple of schools of thought on that. So yeah, I know you talked about it just for a second, but talk a little bit about how you go about talking to clients about how taxes are to be paid when they do that conversion and why it makes sense to do that.
Well, let's say they have a traditional IRA, it's $100,000, and you're going to partial convert over 4 years to get it all out. You don't want to dump it all in 1 year, because the part you convert is taxable. So let's say you take $25,000, and that $25,000 is taxable, okay? So you've got to show it on this year's income tax. And let's say for federal and state tax, I'm making this up completely, but let's just say you're at 30%. So $7,500. If you take it out of your IRA to pay for it, here's why it just takes so much longer. When you take it out, now all of a sudden it's taxable. Now you got to take taxes out of that, you know. And then what do? Then you go back in and take it out of the account again. Then you're going to pay taxes on the taxes that you took out already. I mean, it just keeps on snowballing. And it might take you, says, 6-7 years to break even taxable versus tax-free. Might take 14-15 years. So I just don't think I don't say people can't do it, but they're just kidding themselves. They're better to keep it in there. You need to take it from savings, anything that's not tax deferred.
Okay. So your advice, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Good. I was going to say, I say I've had people take it out of other taxes out of the other tax-free account. And I'll say, well, you're just putting into one and taking out of one, but they'll say, yeah, but when we're paying the taxes, it's not the whole amount. It's just the taxation. Like here, $7,500 on $25,000, and that, you know. So, but I would rather just have it in savings and take it out of savings or out of a individual investment or something that there's not taxation on it.
Sure. Yep. Well, and you already got a reply, Dave. Taxes are going to be due eventually anyway. Eventually, they're going to have to pay taxes on that money decide not to do the conversion based on that scenario because they don't have money sitting aside. Then,
Steve, do you remember that old transmission? It was years ago, maybe 30 years ago. There was no car transmission ad, and there was that real rough looking guy, and he says, "You can pay me now, or you can pay me later."
Right.
And you know what should normally cost more money? Pay it later.
Pay it later. Yeah.
Pay it now. Pay me now. I got to say, pay me now or pay me later. You know what? You might as well pay that Roth conversion money right now. Boom, get out of it. Get in it tax free. Because I guarantee you, virtually, tax rates are going up and not going down in the future.
Yeah, and there is that question of how they impact your Social Security payments and how, I mean, it could affect your Medicare payments now, right, as well, and what you pay for Medicare. So
I feel like the
senators and congressmen are probably leaving those Roth conversions for just a couple more years so they can take advantage of them, and then they'll close that off.
Yeah, you are so politically cynical. If they could go in, they could take it away. They could. They're not going to retro anything like what you've done in the past. Mm-hmm. But the government can do any darn thing. You know, this, you know, from the bipartisan, well, excuse me, for gosh, what was the act? I mean, not bipartisan Secure. Budget Act, but on the Secure Act. Yeah, they came on in and said, first the government says, and you don't have to take any money out for 10 years. Don't have to take any money out for 10 years. And that was on the spousal. No money for 10 years. Well, then they come out and say, hey, we changed it. Now you do have to take money out. But I don't know if you saw this. They didn't change the ruling, but they just rescinded the first 2 years. So the people who didn't take, but you know what? The Roth, there's a lot of Roth money going in right now. And the government likes to get that conversion money up front. I could see them doing away with just putting money into Roth. I don't know. I mean, I just think that's going to be hard to take it away. But who knows what the government, they can do anything they want. All I know is it's a good thing for the common American investor right now to do it.
Yeah, it sure feels like it. Sure feels like it. Good. Let me see if we have any more questions here really quick. This is a long one. Assuming it would be worthwhile, can a Roth conversion apply for someone having an existing 401k with their current employer? I think what they're saying is, could someone that has a 401k convert some of that into a Roth?
Absolutely. As long as they're over the age of 59 and a half and they have an in-service non-hardship withdrawal, and they allow the Roth. I mean, they can come in and say that we only allow the tax deferral, not the Roth. So, but yes. I mean, it is a case where, I don't see whether there's any reason. I don't know if I've done one of those, but I don't see any reason why you couldn't. There was a new law coming up. I can't remember the specifics of it for sure. But it could have been something about a conversion out of a 401k. But if they can't, I think it's up for the Senate. I think it went through Congress already. I think it's up to the Senate now. So if they can't, they should be able to do that in the near future. I work with so many accounts like this. That's never really come on up for me. Mm-hmm. But I don't think there shouldn't.
Shouldn't be a reason why you can't.
I just can't see there's a reason why you can't. Yeah, that'd be my opinion anyway.
Yep. Good. I think that's the last question. Is there anything that you want to add, anything about what you do that you think would make sense for the group to know it, or anything you want to add before we close out today, Dave?
Well, I would say this. You know what? Steven, you know this, but I do my share of security business, and that certainly has been kind of pounded. My fixed index block and fixed block, that's fun. I mean, it's fun to tell people, you know, you haven't gone down a bit, or you got a fixed guaranteed return of even though it's 3%. They're still pretty darn happy with that, with everything else that has gone down. But if you're not seeing a lot of people marketing, I mean, Roth conversion is a hot button for like my show's Retirement Boss Radio. We actually talk about Roth conversions and ways to go in and keep Social Security taxation down. But it's a hot topic. And I'll just say, if you're not marketing right now, you should be, because there's a ton of advisors and insurance agents that have a marketing hangover after the pandemic. Maybe they weren't able, but they still haven't got back
back in the swing of things. Yeah, I was trying to think of a really good word, but back in the swing of things. I mean, doing it like they did pre-pandemic. And I'll tell you right now, there's less competition out there. We have better numbers on our seminars. We have really great numbers on radio. If you're not marketing like you once did, yeah, absolutely. Should mark yes and talk to me, and let's just see if we can help you out from a production standpoint, get in front of more people. Good. And if that's something you want to do, obviously the poll says, hey, if you want more information on Roth conversions, check yes. If it's just a matter of you'd like to maybe spend a few minutes with Dave on the phone and pick his brain about another idea, if you want to see what he's doing marketing wise, what's working or what's not working, it'll be to 10 or 15 minutes, I think that you'll find very worthwhile. And we'll give you a call. Brady will give you a call, and he'll set up an appointment on Dave's calendar for you that's convenient for both you and Dave. And you will be speaking with Dave. You won't be speaking to someone on his team. So you'll get kind of the horse's mouth, if you will, information about what's working and what's not, and
at least what's working and what's not for Dave, and some things that you might look at. He's helped a number of our producers over the years with some really good ideas. So you cannot beat that. And I, you know, zero is no doubt your hero right now. Interest rates going up is certainly, you know, we're seeing right now, you know, our highest, Dave, you're going to hate this, our highest 1 year point to point cap right now is over 10% on the S&P 500.
Why would I hate that? I love that. I love that.
No, you love that.
Oh, no. Here's what happens is you don't have, unless you take out early kinds of surrender charges, you have no risk on the downside, no risk on the interest that's credited, and you can make up to what the average of the S&P has done over the last 50 years. That's pretty tough
thing
to beat, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. Yeah. Right now, yeah. And companies are getting, you know, I can't imagine all the ins and outs of understanding why they're so aggressive, but I do know that they've got better opportunity for spreads than they've had probably in the last 20 years. Because they're, you know, what's happening and what they're seeing, and for their credit rates internally right now, and actually the S&P, even though we're seeing a lot of shrinkage in the value of the S&P, it's a slow, not volatile shrinkage. And so oddly, the option budgets have actually gone down some. So it gives them good opportunity between you know, good money to spend and a relatively low cost for their option budget, that they're having pretty good rates right now. And that's why you see a 10% cap on an S&P. So
Steve, yes, would you say pretty good rates? How long have you been in the business?
I honestly, Dave, I don't know if I've ever seen a straight 10.5 cap on an S&P.
I haven't either. So I'm going to say, you said pretty good rates. Can you reclassify that for me just to make me feel good?
Better than
the best
usual
rates there's the best rates you've ever seen. You know what this is like?
Better than normal.
You know, it's like a reverse gas war. They don't have gas wars anymore. Remember the gas wars way back when? I remember 19 cents a gallon, and they were about 35. But they had gas wars. I really do, and I know there's options, different things. But you know what? I really do believe that if seeing the big stick out there, you know, all of a sudden other companies say, well, you know what? If they're buying business, we will too, just like banks do. I think there's a competition, and right now, it's about as high as I think you'll ever go to see it. I think it's a great time to be in that business. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, and you know, when I was like 8 years old, Dave, and we were driving down the road, and my dad would look and he'd see 12 cents a gallon. He'd say, you know what? That's not bad.
Yeah, I'm sure, like father, like son.
Absolutely. So it's a great time to be in the business. I'm glad you all tuned in for a little bit of information on Roth conversions. If there's anything that we can do to help you, I hope you'll give us a call. Of course, here at the office, 800-255-5055. I see 100% of you did schedule a call with Dave, so that's great. I think you'll find that beneficial. I think you'll all find beneficial time spent there, and maybe pick up an idea, whether it's about Roth conversions or non-hardship 401k withdrawals or Retirement Boss Radio or Social Security seminars. Man, what a great opportunity those have been over the past four or five or 6 years.
Yeah, Steve, I mean, I told you this on the first leg of my Social Security workshop that I did on Tuesday. We had 11 buying units. I got 11 buying units, and I got 9 appointments. Yeah. So, you know what? And I do a lot of those. I mean, you know, I should. But you know what? I got 9 appointments just on that one night. So I had the second half coming in to light it up. We had to do it next week. But I'm gonna get 13 to 15 appointments again, you know, from that workshop. So, and we can never go here, Steve, because we're running out of time. But I just want to say, seminars, hot right now. Hot.
Yeah, they work. You bet. Yep. Yeah, 11 buying units and 9 appointments. You must have been on fire. That's a good.
It was a good. Well, the crowd was with me. It was a good one. And you know what? They can see the value of talking to someone because they can't get it from the Social Security Administration. They can't give advice, but Dave Pimper does, and that's what we can do for you too. Yep.
Well, good. Thank you all for joining us today. Thank you again, Dave, for taking some time out of your schedule. I know you're kind of racked up with appointments right now. Hopefully everybody has that problem. If you don't, give us a call. We'd love to help you. 800-255-5055. Thank you for joining us today. And today being Thursday, have a great Friday, and then hopefully have a great weekend as well. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.